Yo, what up, YouTube fam? Welcome back to the channel, Diskin' Deals coverage. Today, we're in Wichita, Kansas for the 2023 Keeper of the Change, and we get to follow around the defending champ. Let's follow his tourney journey. With defending champ Lauren Lewis. We're going to learn about him right now. Lauren, it's the day of the tournament. What was for breakfast?
I had a pita bread sausage, egg, and cheese thing.
Oh, you fancy.
That was okay.
Okay, where'd you get it from?
Spangles.
Okay.
It's right down the street.
Yeah. Do you have Spangles where you live?
Mm-mm, no.
Okay, so it's a luxury to be here in Wichita.
Yeah, for sure. Absolutely.
All right, so tell me this. How long have you been playing the game of disc golf?
A little over 10 years
okay. so far. Wow. And so a decade. And how long have you been playing?
Don't say it like that.
How long have you been a professional?
About 4 years, I think. Something like that. 4 or 5 years.
I love it. And if for people that aren't familiar with your game, what would you say are the stronger parts of your disc golf game?
Usually putting. However, here lately, I haven't had a lot of time to practice, so we'll see how that goes today. I'm going to be practicing a lot on the practice basket. And forehand upshots, I'm usually really good at those, so hopefully I can get close. That way I don't have to rely on the putting so much.
Okay, I love that. And so speaking of not having enough time to play, I know last year you added a new member to the family, a daughter, Raina.
Yeah.
Is that the reason why you've not been able to practice? Has she changed how often you get to play, or has not much changed there?
A little bit, for sure. Priority shift, and you have to stay there and take care of her a little bit. And I've been working a lot more, too, so that just makes it a little more difficult. But we do get out at least once a weekend, sometimes during the week, too, so I'm not missing too much.
Okay. I love it. And so, Has Raina been out on the course with you?
Oh, yeah. She's played over a dozen rounds so
far.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah.
Has she thrown?
No.
She's not still that to that
yeah,
level.
Yeah.
Okay.
She just hangs out with
can
us.
Can she walk? Is she walking yet?
She's close.
Okay.
She stands on her own, but she can't go anywhere.
Okay. I love it.
She's a heckler more than anything.
Okay. That's right. Okay. That's good. That's good for the soul. That's good practice because you might end up playing with Keenan here. So
yeah, that's true.
It's
you hear him three holes away.
Exactly. All right. So let's jump into talking about last year. You won this tournament. Winning in the pro field is hard in general. Defending a title is even harder. Does winning last year add any extra pressure for this year?
Yeah, a little bit. I had double booked this tournament with a tournament in McAllister, and I chose to come here so I could, you know, defend that title. And so hopefully I can get out here and do what I need to do to get it taken care of.
Okay. I love it. Finally, before we jump into the action, any shout outs you'd like to give?
For sure. My wife, thank you so much for being very supportive and, you know, all that stuff. Basket Case Disc Golf in Tulsa. They've helped me out immensely. And Gateway Disc Sports.
Love it. And finally, it's early here. We're going to start our round at Clap West. And I know you told me off camera you're coming into this blind.
Yeah.
But luckily, we're here early enough. You may get to see a few holes. But good luck this weekend. Have fun, man. And kill it out there.
Absolutely. Thank you.
All right. Let's jump into the action. Hello, welcome in everyone. You got One Time Deal commentary with me, Lucas Deal, and the one-time world champ himself, Chris Smith. Smitty, how you doing today?
I'm good, Lucas. Thanks for letting me come help you out with this.
Absolutely. So we got first round coverage of the Keeper of the Chains, presented by Dux and Innova. And I think we even got another sponsor here, Grip Equipment. So let's jump right in here to hole two and tell me about it, Smitty.
Hole two is 336 feet, slightly uphill. The drone is flying under the gap that I'm assuming Lauren's going to try to hit. It's going to be up above there. And, you know, just get out there and hopefully get yourself a putt on this one.
Yeah, this one I don't think plays too difficult.
Sixth easiest hole.
Yeah, and this is one you definitely want to get, but it's not a gimme by any stretch of the imagination. I don't know the best line to get there. I think the over-the-top shot is tough to get the distance you want.
Yeah, unless you have, a cannon. I've seen Nolan throw it to it multiple times, but I don't know much about Lauren's game. I don't know anything about his bag, but that looks like that's going to be a putt to start him off.
Yeah, so you're going to see out of Lauren a lot of Gateway discs. So okay. He's sponsored by Gateway. So that was an Aztec? No, I don't know.
So we're about, 37 feet here, it looks like?
Yeah.
No wind, according to the leaves.
Yeah, it was a still day. This was a squirrel day for sure.
Yeah, that's a classic first putt nerves, I would think, right there.
Yeah, he's a great putter, and he's a completely straddle putter. So every putt, no matter what, he's never in line. He's always straddle.
And the defending champ.
Yes, he is.
Cleaned it up with no problems, so off to a good start.
Yep. No blemishes on the scorecard, so we'll jump right into hole three.
Okay, hole three plays at 411 feet. If you have a massive arm, you can hyzer over the top. Most people will try to either flick if they have that or anhyzer around the left. Kind of a bonus birdie for sure. Day like today, though, all shots are open. Anhyzers, rollers. Well, I'm assuming Lauren's probably going to go flick, I would guess. I'm not 100% sure. Nope.
He is over the top. Actually has some massive power. I haven't really seen him play either, and I was like, this dude crushes. So you're going to see him over the top shot here. This is a spell. Like I said, I'm not very familiar with the Gateway disc, but if that's how you can throw a spell, maybe I'll get one. Because that's
pretty good. Yeah, pretty not nice. Even flat, just straight hyzer the whole way, that's one funny. Angle. He liked it. Oh, I can tell why. Oh my gosh. What, 12 feet?
Yeah, oh yeah. Yeah, well inside and...
Easy.
Easy money.
Yeah, that's a good one to get for sure.
Yeah, that's... That one...
Yeah. Ninth hardest right in the middle.
Yep, and then here's hole four. I like this hole. I think it's fun.
Yeah, hole four is a, 300, just under 300 feet downhill. As long as you don't hit one of these three trees we're passing right here, you're going to have a putt. The only thing that worries me is hitting that dry ground and skipping into the creek.
Yeah, and then they did shave the greens, and I thought that was interesting. I think it made some of the normal shots a little more interesting than previous years.
Yeah, I wasn't a huge fan of it because, the goal in disc golf is to put the disc close, and now they're trying to get us to land at 30 feet and slide up there. So, that's perfect.
Yeah, this is a blade, and yeah, that was a money shot.
That's perfect.
And he's coming into this blind, so he's never seen these holes. I think he got to play the first four before the round, but he had never seen them.
And hole four is right in the middle of the pack, playing 2.84 scoring average. So, there's a little bit of meat left on this bone. Definitely not a gimme.
And it's early, too, so those putting nerves are still high.
Not too high.
Yeah, so he smashed it.
Yeah.
He's a great putter, like I said, and the straddle looks sweet.
Well, yeah, after three holes, big drive and good putting. You should be at the top.
The monster of hole four.
Yeah.
Or hole five.
Hole five. Throw as far as you can. Try to get close. Make a putt. As long as you stay in the fairway on this, you're guaranteed a par at worst, I would think. You'd have to throw a bad shot somewhere to not get a par. And, after seeing Lauren on hole three, I think birdie is probably going to have a birdie putt in his future, I would assume.
Yeah, and that sidewalk that plays right down the middle, it's not OB. It's just a part of the fairway. I kind of wish they would have made that play one way or the other just to give this hole more than just a, hey, let's throw it far.
Right. I mean, yeah. Add some skill to it.
Yeah. Now, I told Lauren just throw this. He's asking a few pointers, and this is the same one he threw on hole two. It's the Apex. And so, yeah, this one, you just blast down there.
Smoked it down pretty good.
Yeah. I said just throw it as far as you can.
That looked like pretty easy distance. Probably cut it in half, I would guess.
And so he wished he would have known a little bit where that basket was. He couldn't quite see it. And he wanted to be more left. He didn't like how high he was going to have to get this. Yep. So
yeah, left is actually better because it gives you room to drive it through the air versus volley pop it up. Did that miss the tree or hit the tree?
It got through, yeah.
So he is going to have a putt.
He was laughing at the gap he hit.
Long putt, death putt, lay it up.
Yep, and he definitely did.
You're not giving up strokes to a lot of the field on this hole by taking a par. It played at 4.2, so it's the fourth hardest hole on the course. So par's great. Especially no worry par like that one.
And I think that's one he definitely wanted to get, though, after seeing it. Hole six.
This is as must get as a hole can get on this course. The drone is flying the path that I'm assuming nobody is going to take. This is, as far as hyzers go, gentle hyzer with mid-range. This is about as easy as it gets. The green is a little bit interesting with that bump. It's a little bit steeper than it appears there. So, going flick, huh?
Yeah. So, wow. Again, remember, blind to the course. And I think he was top of the box or second off the box, and I think the first person went flick as well.
I actually like this hole better before they cleared out that dirt in the middle. Yeah. Oh, yeah. He only hit a tree, so that's going to keep him fairly close, I think.
Yeah, he sawed it off a little bit, though. He wasn't completely happy.
And here we can get a good view of the shaved green you were talking about. So 35 feet, you know, up and down, a little bit of a slope. Worst thing to do here would be to face mask. Anything else would be fine.
Keep in mind, Smitty has not seen this, so this is not foreshadowing.
Yeah. I'm going in blind. Oh boy, Stanford. Okay. Yep.
So he went to the good side if you're going to miss.
Yeah, I mean, this is a lot steeper than it looks on camera.
And I do like the location of this pin because of that.
Mm-hmm.
I think it definitely adds some interest.
Yeah, it's a fun green for sure.
And then hole seven.
Hole seven. 342, downhill. You can shoot this gap here if you want. That's what normal folk have to do. If you have a big enough gun, you can go over the trees. I've seen that done successfully as well. OB's, 30 feet behind maybe?
Yeah, I think it's even closer than that.
Yeah, so if you get it flat and going, you're going to bring that into play for sure.
And so it should be noted here, and I'm going to foreshadow this a little bit, but there are a couple tees on this.
Let's not sugarcoat it. These tees suck. They're so slippery. I mean, if you're approaching a tee pad worried about your footing, you're losing half the battle.
Yeah, watch this here, too.
Yeah, you see, and to have brand new tee pads with that terrible of a finish on them to start off is a total waste of time and effort.
And what stinks for him is that was, that's, you're asking for injury.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, and a bad shot to boot, of course, but.
Yeah, the whole reason for cement tee pads is to take the risk of slipping and injury out, and. Man, I'd rather throw off a grass than some of those. Yeah. I usually try to throw from the middle, like back from the end, because I don't feel like it's back there.
Hey, Lauren, and I do think in the tournament, that was a good soft approach there. But I do think they gave the option of going to the side on most of these tees, so that was nice.
You could tee off from one side. It was marked with the flag, and yeah, so you did have that option.
And hole 8 here, across the creek.
260, low burner. The sidewalk does play OB, so you got to be careful. Probably a mid-range of some sort for Lauren. I don't know what the gateway mid-range is, but...
Yeah, I think he's going to end up grabbing. He's trying to figure out if it's a forehand or a backhand for him. He's asking about the sidewalk.
All of the
I've seen people forehand out to the left of that tree, and, you know, it's a safe play. It's a 3 for sure, and the sidewalk's never an issue. But I just feel like the straight shot's just too easy to not go for.
Yeah, and I think he made the same decision. He's going to go with an assassin. And I will say that a strong part of Lauren's game that he didn't even comment on in our interview was his ability to throw the disc straight. He does a very good job.
Let's go, dude.
As we can see there, that should be such a tough shot. Chip in, no problem. Oh, yeah.
I think that this time the shaved green really helped out.
Yeah, helped him slide up there a little bit.
And hole 9.
This is a classic hole. Clear back to the original clap design. You gotta nail it to get a putt on this. You'll see a lot of flip hyzer flips, you'll see rollers. The interesting thing is the way the fairway narrows as you get to the top. These last three trees really pinch it off. So 344 uphill, hole 9 plays is right in the middle again, 8th hardest hole. Is this the same disc?
Don't know what he's throwing here. I was asking him about it. He's like, I asked him way late, and so he's like, I'm jumbled up. So he got through 8, and we're done now.
We're done.
So now we're just guessing at this point.
It looks like that same disc.
This could be a light blue one. I think this might be his distance one, which is that apex.
Mm. That's good. That's a great shot.
Yeah.
Probably edge of circle.
Yeah, so I think edge of circle, so a little outside. So essentially the same putt he had to start his round, but this one, of course, a little uphill.
And he's in the flow and playing well. Being 3 down after 8 holes is fine on this course. Full-time straddle putt would be nice, man. You'd never have to worry about straddling around a tree. It would just be your putt every time. Oh, yeah. Nice. Count it.
Yeah, that stuck. And I think we get to take another view of that one. For any ladies watching, this man is married, so stop looking at that booty. All right. Hole 10.
Yep. Once again, this drone is not flying where Lauren's going to throw. For a right-hander, this is a hyzer all day long, I would say. Unless you had a serious left-to-right wind, then you might try to go down the middle. But that actually brings OB on the left side into play more. I'd be shocked if Lauren does anything but just hyzers out around the tree. If you're a lefty on this one, you're toast.
Yeah, this is not a good hole for a lefty.
Is he eyeballing the middle?
He is.
Good God. What kind of caddy are you, man?
I tried to tell him, but he felt comfortable up the middle. He didn't want to bring the OB into question.
Yeah, why not? Yeah. Oh, did it happen?
Oh, almost did.
It was a great line.
Yeah,
it was.
The middle is just so low.
Yeah. But like I said, a good part of his game is the ability to throw straight.
Well, that never hurt anybody in disc golf. There you go, up and down. That's all right. Par's okay. I mean, what is this hole? 10?
10.
Third hardest hole.
Yep, and just like that, I mean...
I can't believe that hole would play that hard.
9 holes in, and You're looking, he's four down through nine. I mean, that's a good start.
Yeah.
So make sure you all head on back, watch the back nine. It'll be listed right here, so you can go ahead and click on that. Smitty, thanks for joining me.
You bet.
As always, everyone, take care, and bye-bye now.